Hello and welcome back to another video with It's Dr. Dan, and today we're just going to go over what a brief introduction of chemical reactions is, what we're going to be learning about next. Now, what does it mean by a chemical reaction? Well, this is the entire purpose of taking chemistry, is trying to understand what happens when we have different chemicals that react together. This is something that's found all throughout your entire life, everywhere around you. So in the background here, I have images of all kinds of different processes that are stuff you probably do every single day. So for example, digestion, right? We all love to eat and we eat every single day. That process is every time you eat something, all those different chemicals that you are ingesting into your body get broken down into thousands of individual molecules that get used for all their different resources to help you live and to be able to do all the metabolic activities that you do every day just by moving and breathing. So you are doing millions and trillions of reactions every single second. Other things that we do, right? Right now, you're watching this video on a laptop or a phone. The batteries in your device are a chemical reaction. As the chemicals get excited, they transfer electrons to help power your device and to allow it to be going. If you had to drive to school, right, and you used a normal gas-powered car, you used a combustion reaction where the gasoline burned and helped propel your car. Same thing if you're like, oh, I drive an electric car. Well, go back to batteries, and that's the same idea of powering your vehicle. If you have, let's say, a bunch of stuff like laying around in your backyard and they're rusting in the sun and in the atmosphere, and you see that metal and it's starting to turn different colors, well, that is another example. Right, we just went through a pandemic where it was pretty much told, like, hey, wash your hands every second you get to try to eliminate exposure to different germs, and something you should do every day anyway. Why do you do that? Well, putting soap on your hands helps destroy bacterial cell walls to help stop them from reproducing, helps destroy them. If you're someone that loves cooking or baking or creating things in your own kitchen, all these are also chemical reactions. You're over the age of 21 in the US and you love to drink on the weekends, potentially, all that process, how is it all made? Fermentation, right? The creation of alcohol is something that's a common process. Or just fermentation of making, like, let's say, cheeses or bread or different vinegars and different things like that. They're also all made using microorganisms to create a lot of the other different food sources we use on a regular day. So chemical reactions are everywhere. And since the very beginning of chemistry, one of the things that I say in a lot of my videos is, well, what's the thing that we're really doing? And it's trying to understand how and why matter changes. And that's the idea of trying to understand this next chapter worth of videos, is seeing how exactly do we see these reactions all over the place, right? If you have the unfortunate of driving a car that's, you know, a little worse for wear, and you see that, hey, it's starting to rust a little bit, you know, it still runs great, but it's starting to fall apart a little bit, that is a chemical reaction. If you ever see money sitting on the sidewalk and it's been there for a really long time, you'll see that oxidation layer on it. That is another chemical reaction. If you have fruit, or if that's been sitting maybe on your counter for a little too long, it starts turning black, still tastes sort of okay. It tastes a little different. Now, why is that? Well, once again, it's reactions at work. So we're going to be really looking and trying to dive into these and try to understand exactly what it is that we're seeing. Now, with all these chemical reactions, all are surrounded via chemical change, right? There was physical changes, which was just kind of changing the form of something, going from like a solid, a liquid, to a gas, maybe breaking it or tearing it or doing different changes of the shape. Chemical changes, when the molecules, they rearrange and create something completely new, right? So, and how can you see these? Well, some of them are color changes, right? If you are cooking at home and let's say you have a meat on the grill, right? Originally, it's like a pink red color, but then it starts browning, the aromas change, the smell changes, the colors change. This is a chemical reaction that's right in front of you. If you have a precipitation occur, let's say a solid is all of a sudden made, where you mix two liquids together and then all of a sudden a solid comes out of it, like, how is that even possible? Well, due to the solubility rules of different ionic compounds, you could actually be making precipitation, which we will be covering as well in videos in this series. Now, if there's a gas that comes up, right? If one of the diatomic gases is created, Or if you have all these different CO2 or ammonia or all these different aromas that come off as well, or odors, these are gases, right? If you can all of a sudden, those didn't smell like anything, and all of a sudden start smelling, all of a sudden you have a chemical reaction, right? If there's an odor that comes out of nowhere in your house, it's like, well, where's that coming from? Well, that's a chemical reaction that is occurring somewhere. If you have light that is being created, electromagnetic radiation, where electrons are getting excited, they're relaxing down, and we can see that light that comes from the electrons, that is another process. Or heat with thermochemistry, where all of a sudden something can absorb a bunch of energy, it can change how the temperatures, how it behaves, how we can actually see it. Maybe it will get colder, right? The heat packs or cold packs. These are all different types of chemical reactions. So we're going to be really looking at this picture and trying to get a little idea. So before we do that, let's take a look at some different demonstrations. Chemical reactions can be some of the coolest looking reactions that we can ever see, and they can be some of the silliest ones too. So for this one, I thought this was a really cool color change where it goes from blue to clear, and you're going to see it turn back to blue. So this is an iodine clock reaction where it keeps changing and circulating, oscillating colors over and over and over again. So this is one of those things where there's a color change. It was clear, it went from to gold, then to blue, and it kept oscillating. This is a chemical change. Another example that you might have seen in class potentially could have also been in the form of fire, right? One of the things that I love to show to my students when we're learning about electrons and how they get excited is how fire can essentially show how light can be emitted differently, right? So all right here, there's a bunch of different salts that are ionic compounds that if they absorb a ton of their energy through thermochemistry, you can see they all have different colors to them. And it's all about the different energetics, right? As these things are transforming and changing, their molecules and atoms are rearranging into different structures. We can actually see how they could actually exude and exhibit light as a result. So this is some of the examples that you can see in your chemistry course. Now, what is this as simple as, oh, can I just watch all these different test tubes? Sometimes it is. You're just mixing things together and seeing what you observe. When you're observing a chemical reaction, you write down everything you are observing. You put excruciating detail into what you're doing. Now, this goes the same for why is this skill so important? Many people that take my courses are health science majors, meaning that you're going to be taking care of patients. Maybe you're someone who just wants to be a scientist or an engineer or a physicist or a chemist or a biologist, but your entire career is based on observation. So you need to be able to write down what you're seeing. You also need to be able to scientifically explain what you're seeing as well. So how exactly can that work? Well, if you're trying to look at a chemical equation, the way that we show this is we have the reactants and the products, meaning the reactants are what you start with in a reaction. The products are what you are creating. Now, the way that we convey these is typically that you will see a bunch of chemicals written down with an arrow pointing towards the products, illustrating exactly what it is you are making reaction. And the way to kind of think of this is it's very similar to if you're cooking at home, where if you're trying to follow a recipe and you are baking, well, you could have all your ingredients that you're starting off with, your flour, your sugar, your milk, your eggs. These are your reactants. You can mix them all together to create a cake, bread, or something completely new. So you're yielding or creating these. So this is what we're going to be learning how to do, is how to balance these chemical reactions, how to predict them. And this is going to be something that's going to be coming up shortly for the weeks to come. So we will try to make this a big component. Now, when we are illustrating all these different substances, not only are we producing or yielding things, but we're going to be using familiar symbols to illustrate our phase changes as well. So whether it's a solid, a liquid, or a gas, you will see these written in parentheses next to your substance to illustrate, oh, okay, this is the phase it's occurring. Because if you think about it, intermolecular forces, which is stuff that's been talked about a lot, help pull these chemicals together to help them start to react and start to change and to actually cause a big impact on this. So this is something that you need to be able to illustrate exactly what it is that you saw, what phase was it in, because it changes exactly how you're conveying that information from one person to the other. Now, if you have a Q, what is that? Well, if you don't remember, aqueous means that it's dissolved in water. So thinking ion-dipole interaction, it was soluble, it broke apart, it's in water, which is a big component. Sometimes the water participates in the reaction, and you need to show that. If you see a triangle written, think delta T, back to thermochemistry. This is all about heat is being used. So delta means, or triangle. So they're all little important little tidbits that we'll see in these different reactions. Now, most of these are written as chemical equations, and this is a skill that you need to know in order to master chemistry. It takes a lot of practice to be able to get comfortable using these, and it's something that you will get a lot of experience doing as you go through dozens and hundreds of problems trying to really get a hold of this. But it's a simple concept, if you think about it, is essentially whatever I put into the reaction is what is going to be coming out. So meaning that if I have, on the left-hand side, I have two atoms of hydrogen are combining with two atoms of oxygen. But one thing that you notice is that it's not equal on both sides. Now that's breaking a rule, isn't it? If you remember, there was conservation of mass, which chemical reactions and what they show is that whatever matter goes into the reaction must come out. Remember, matter or mass cannot be created nor destroyed, the fundamental law of our world. So essentially, if we go put whatever is in, we need to balance the chemical equation. And the way that we will do that is by using coefficients in order to do that. So when you see chemical reactions, you will see numbers written in front of them, just like this, where, okay, in this reaction, I wanted to balance both sides. So what you see is if you do 2 times 2 hydrogens, that means you have a total of 4, right? And that's combining with 2 oxygens and it's creating 2 water molecules. But total, right, we have 4 hydrogens and 2 oxygens. You can essentially carry through the mathematics here. Just to illustrate exactly how this works and how you're going to be doing this in homework, is in every problem, you always got to make sure it's balanced. Do not always expect that it is. It's something that you need to double check for yourself and get comfortable doing. So if we were to look at this, let's say I had the following reaction. How exactly does this work? Well, if I have a 2 in front of sodium hydroxide up here, how that's going to actually work is the 2 gets distributed to each element that's in this formula. So that means you have 2 sodiums, 2 oxygens, and 2 hydrogens. Now, that doesn't mean you're going to put little subscripts next to all these. It just tells you have 2 sodium hydroxide compounds that are reacting with 1 magnesium nitrate compound to create 2 sodium nitrates and 1 magnesium hydroxide. These represent how many moles of a compound you have within your chemical formula. So you can kind of get an idea. It's like, oh no, it's going to come back to moles as well. It tells you exactly what it is that you're seeing. Okay, so this is the basic idea of how we're going to be looking at chemical reactions, which we'll eventually get into how you can actually balance and write out these little equations. So we will be going into my next video in this series, how to balance chemical equations, using this how-to guide of going through them and trying to practice it as much as possible. This is going to be a skill that's going to be used in essentially introductory chemistry and general chemistry. And if you are a chemistry or biology major, it's something that you will see throughout your entire scientific studies. So practice it, master it, and fully understand it, okay? So thank you so much for listening. I hope this video helped you get a basic idea of chemical reactions. And thank you so much for watching and listening. I hope to see you all later. Bye now.